As Nigerians are slowly adjusting to the lockdown in Lagos, Abuja and Ogun State, some residents in Ebute Metta axis of Lagos State defied the lockdown, agitating over lack of palliatives from the federal government. Mary Chinda has details, and joining us live on Plus TV Africa correspondent is Mary. Thank you, Mary, for joining us.
Thank you.
Now, you were on the streets. Bring us up to speed to what the situation was like on the street.
Well, day two of the stay-at-home directive issued by the president on Sunday. If you look at the when the president was making the speech and asking Nigerians, it seemed from a government that actually cares about its people. And then the core of asking people to stay at home is to ensure that, you know, they forestall the spread of the virus. Now, day one across Lagos, the major streets of Lagos that I visited within the island and, of course, on the mainland showed that I would say that there was almost a 90% compliance, because as I said yesterday, men of the Nigeria police were all over the place, men of the Lagos Neighborhood and Security Corps were there, men of the Nigerian Army were there, and people were complying because, of course, they had between Sunday and Tuesday, you know, to begin to make the plans and all of that. So yesterday, for day one, it was people adhered. But today, it's so amazing how Nigerians are already getting agitated. They're like, look, we can't stay. How are we going to stay at home? What are we staying at home for 14 days? Some people are complaining they don't have food. You know, others are saying we don't have money. If we don't work, how are we going to feed? How can you keep us at home without providing essential, you know, the essentials for us, especially money? So that is the tone. It's that of despondency, that of, you know, dissatisfaction over what is happening. And it's amazing how most of the people that I spoke to at Ebute Metta today cared less about their health, cared less about the spread of the coronavirus disease, as much as they cared about the fact that they are going hungry.
All right, just so your thoughts right there. Mary Chinda was on the streets yesterday and today. Let's take a look at this report.
The streets of Lagos looking deserted. But in some parts of Lagos mainland, the streets are so alive and buzzing and crammed with people. Residents are bored of sitting in at home following the mandatory quarantine.
Day two of the stay-at-home directive by the president following the outbreak of COVID-19. In this part of Lagos, Ebute Metta, the residents seem to be having a hard time staying at home as they are complaining about having inadequate funds and access to food to keep them for the next 14 days.
I'm not going to stay 14 days now. You get the thing don't become another thing.
At the para, I never chopped since yesterday. Now ball at the play. Eh? So they make myself day happy. Eh? For this country, what's in the happen?
There's nothing to stay at home with. So a lot of, like now, people are coming now because it's not easy staying at home.
My sister didn't tire me, nothing. I don't get anything to say. They make me go gaga. No food, no money, nothing, nothing. Salt, self, sugar to take, drink, nothing.
They say that they share money. I think my own account, no, they don't. I did go check my ATM every day, I don't see anything there. I never see anybody where they say collect self. I understand, with the money, even the one where individual donate, we don't know where you enter. This virus, where they talk about self, hungry, big pass, I'm understand? No virus, where big pass hungry.
How you go take the chop?
All fingers are not equal. Some people, on a daily basis, when they come back, then they get waiting them to get job.
For how long this may last, or how well this 14-day directive to stay at home would be, only the days will tell. Mary Chinda reporting for Plus TV Africa.
Now back to you, Mary. Amongst those you interacted with on the street, how would you say, do you think they understood the need for the shutdown? How was their appreciation for the shutdown?
I would say that 60% they do not appreciate the need for the shutdown.
Did they understand the need?
They do not seem to understand the need for the shutdown. So they do not appreciate the need for the shutdown. Their focus basically is on the fact that they are hungry. It's about their hungry stomachs more than their health.
Which was their major concern.
Yes, and it seems you know, one would just be bewildered by that kind of perception of what it is that's going on. I remember one of the older women that I spoke with, and she said to me, you know what, Corona cannot kill me, it is hunger that will kill me. And that is a strong, a well-built belief that these people around there have. But maybe that's because that's on the side of the mainland. For people on day one, in fact, the day before the ban, on Monday, you know, people who are on the island are people who are similarly, you know, more educated and more exposed and all of this.
Not necessarily, so.
But basically, yes. So, but they actually understand. So I'm saying that for people who are on the upper echelon, people who are very educated, they care more about, you know, the spread of the disease. If you looked at the report on Monday, people were seen in markets, even though they were making last minute buying, they were actually putting on face masks, people were putting on gloves, people were maintaining social distancing. But in this part of Butemeta, people were crowded together. All that mattered was, look, I need to buy food because I need to take care of myself before thinking about coronavirus disease.
Okay, now if you can't, can you tell us what was the general disposition out there, the general feeling of people? Was that of hope or despondency?
It is despondency. It is first fear, and then fear degenerating now to dissatisfaction, despondency, anger, the feeling of, look, the government doesn't care about us, the feeling of comparing Nigeria, how Nigeria is handling the COVID-19 crisis with how the US is handling the COVID-19 crisis, with how other countries are handling the COVID-19 crisis. People think that other governments are taking care of its people, take their citizens more seriously than the Nigerian government has handled the COVID-19 crisis for them.
Mm-hmm. Now, Lagos State seemed to be like the epicenter of this virus here in Nigeria.
Yes.
Now, do you think the shutdown of Lagos State, the Federal Capital Territory and Ogun State, as it were, do you think it sends home any signal to let people know that, you know, for real, COVID-19 is here with us? Because some people still don't believe, as we speak, that, you know, COVID-19 does exist.
Never has it dawned on people that COVID-19 is real. You know, the first thing when it first came up, people thought, oh, it was a propaganda, oh, it's just something that was set up by government because, you know, some people want to siphon money and all of that. But the government taking, the state government first, you know, the Lagos state government had actually started off with saying, okay, we're going to do a temporary lockdown and all of that before the federal government took this up. This has sent signals to the fact that, look, there is COVID-19. You need to take care of yourself as much as you can. And that's the reason for the stay-at-home directive of the federal government.
With a few people you did interact with yesterday and today, what do you think, I mean, indirectly, is their message to the government?
The message to the government is, look, we need palliatives. If you want us to stay at home, you've got to care about us. You've got to, you know, get the food to us. You've got to provide money. And it's also a blame game, you know, from the citizens to the government, because they're thinking that, look, this has been with us for almost 5 weeks. And if you're saying there's going to be a lockdown, couldn't you have thought all of the 3 weeks, all of the first 3 weeks or the first 4 weeks, didn't you have enough time to say, okay, we're going to disburse these amount of monies through the local government channels, through BVNs or whatever, to the ordinary Nigerians? Because truly, people are suffering. As much as donations are being made by well-meaning Nigerians and people, the government is earmarking some amount of money to combat this, but people are going hungry, and that's the reason people are afraid, people are angry, people want to fight you. If you sneeze, people want to fight you.
All right, great. You were on the street yesterday and including this morning, and so you were closer to the pulse of the people. Now, what do you think the government can do more to allay and address the fear and concerns of the average man and woman on the street?
Get financial palliatives to the doorstep of the ordinary Nigerian. Provide the essentials. Let there be proper electricity. Let them have access to water. Let there be electricity. Make data cheaper. Look, never before have people had to go on the internet like they are going now. An idle man is the devil's workshop, right? And we're saying, okay, we're actually even running into a fear of people taking into crime, people taking into vices. So please, let there be light. Let people work from home. Let there also be concession with data. That's what any reasonable government would do.
Mary Chinda, thank you very much for joining us on News
thank
on
you
the
very
Hour.
Much, Benny, yeah.